Hey guys, I thought I would give a little bit of introduction about the peripheral smear to you guys, and for that I would go into certain cases, and by learning those cases I think we can cover most of the peripheral smear findings in general as well. So if you look at this is a virtual slide. And just something which I got from, or rather I am using the slide of University of British Columbia, and that is their Hematopathology Atlas. It's a virtual slide, and shortly we'll be going into the slide proper, but before that I'll give you a general idea of how this works. So what you're seeing is basically the entire slide. I will magnify into that soon, but on the right corner you can see, the below right corner you can see the magnified image, that is whichever area that I am focusing in the proper slide, it will be magnified on the right lower corner. So if anyone wants to know the morphology better, you can have a look at the right lower corner. So suppose this is this particular case is of a 7-year-old child from Africa, and he came to the casualty with acute pain in the leg, and a peripheral smear was done for this child. So let's go into the higher magnification, and before that we have a certain order for reporting of peripheral smear. First we look at the RBC series, then we look at the WBC series, and lastly we look at the platelet series. An order is good to understand the or to not leave out anything, so we can have a look at every kind of cell or every kind of findings, so that we don't miss out on anything. Anyway, we'll follow that order, that is first RBCs, then WBCs, and then the platelets. And hopefully we'll come to a diagnosis soon. So I'm going to the higher magnification. So firstly, what we have to understand is the morphology of the RBC is what we look into first. And morphology means first is the normocytic normochromic is a general normal description for an RBC. That is, it has a normal size and normal chromia, that is a normal hemoglobin content. And because the color of the RBC is determined by the content of hemoglobin that it carries. So let's look into this case. Firstly, I am looking for a small mature lymphocyte, and I think I would go a little slow, because with that or by the time I explain, you also can get a general idea about the smear, your own idea and your own diagnosis by the time I start explaining. So I think this is quite slow enough for everybody. And so what we are looking for is a small mature lymphocyte. That is because an RBC is the size of an RBC is compared with the nucleus of a small mature lymphocyte. So if it is approximately equal to the nucleus of the small mature lymphocyte, we call it normocytic, and if it is smaller we call it microcytic, and if it is larger we call it macrocytic. And before going into that, this particular finding came up here, so I will go just to give a little explanation about that here. This cell that you're seeing is the normoblast, and if you want to see a better image, you can see the right hand corner below. That is a normoblast, because if you look at the cytoplasm, it is as red, or it has the same color as the RBCs that are near it. So it is an RBC series, and it is not a lymphocyte. You may doubt it for a lymphocyte, but if you look at the cytoplasm or the that is very similar to the RBCs around it, and the nucleus is very much condensed, so that is a normoblast. So this finding, this smear has a normoblast in it, and so that was not a lymphocyte, that was a normoblast. So we'll again move a little bit to find if any lymphocytes are around. Okay, so this is a small mature lymphocyte. If you look, the cytoplasm is not like what you saw just before, and if you look at it, the RBCs near it has a size that is much smaller than the nucleus of this lymphocyte. So generally the RBCs here are having a microcytic appearance. And if you look at the color, you have to also comment on the chromia. So normally the color is like the pallor, the central pallor is 1/3 of the entire diameter of the RBCs. And let's see if there is any hypochromia in this case, but usually the microcytic hypochromic comes together. So there is usually going to be hypochromia, but it is not very evident in the smear. But when there is microcytic, we usually go with the micro means hypochromic, but this case it is not very evident. So let's go into the other findings. There is an isopoikilocytosis, that is, there is variation in the size as well as the shape of the RBCs, and these are target cells, so that looks like targets. So we have an isopoikilocytosis with target cells, and the most evident finding basically is the large number of sickled RBCs that that are seen in the smear. And I guess most of you must have already noticed that before I have mentioned about it now. So this is a sickled RBC. If you look at the right insert, right right corner, right lower corner, this is the sickled RBC. And a sickle RBC does not have a central pallor, and it has a sharp outline, and it has a sickle shape. And some of them doesn't really have a sickle shape, but some have a boat-like shape. This has a boat-like shape. Here it is more of a sickle shape. But in this smear, I think most are kind of boat shaped with less of a sickle shape. Anyway, both are counted as a sickle cell. So this also, if you look into this particular cell, it has more of a bluish color compared to the RBC near it. So that is because it is immature RBC, or what you call a polychromatic RBC. So polychromatic RBCs are again an immature RBCs. We have already seen a normoblast, and now we are seeing a polychromatic RBC, and actually most of the other cells here are sickled RBCs. So this patient probably came with a crisis, because the leg pain is actually a pain crisis, and the normoblasts are not much, but when you see normoblast, especially a large number of them, that means it supports the crisis, and the patient really has a lot of polychromasia as well. So why does this this pain crisis occur? That is because the sickle RBCs will go on and clog the small minor or small blood vessels and capillaries, and as a result those tissues will have an ischemic attack, or necrosis, that kind of means a hypoxic situation, and that is when the pain kicks in. That is how you get the pain crisis in sickle cell disease. There are many types of crisis in sickle. That is something that you will have to read about. So here again you are seeing a sickle cell. Now if you look at the RBCs, so I think that's enough about the RBC series. If you look at the WBCs here, this is a neutrophil. This again is a neutrophil. We have already seen lymphocytes around, and here again is the neutrophil. This is what you call a smudge cell or a basket cell. I'm just mentioning it. It has no significance with a sickle cell anemia, but this is what you call a smudge cell or a basket cell, and this usually occurs. Means we can see a little bit of them in most smears, but it is very much increased in a condition called CLL, or chronic lymphocytic leukemia, but that I'm just saying it passingly. This is a monocyte. If you look at it, it's a monocyte. It has vacuolated cytoplasm, abundant bluish gray cytoplasm, and kind of a large nucleus. Actually most of them are kidney shaped. Here it is not much of a kidney shaped. And here's again a neutrophil. I think that's enough about the WBC series, and we'll go more about the RBC series. sorry, the platelet series. So if you look, there are platelets, 1, 2, 3, 4, many platelets are there. In one oil field, you have to have about 8 to 24 platelets. And if you have that, then that is an adequate, like that person has adequate amount of platelets in his blood. So I think this smear, that is enough for the smear. So this patient basically has sickle cell disease, and you should never miss a sickle cell in the smear. Right, I'm just go a little slower for anyone to notice. Actually, sickle cells are all around the smear. Wherever you look, there is sickle. See, the sharp edges are there. Right, so, but many are boat shaped, but we can also find the sickled RBCs here and there. But see, the boat shaped cells are also considered as sickle cells. In fact, and there's another kind of cell that we consider as sickle, that is the hovel leaf. Morphology, that is also considered as sickle cell. So I think that's about it, and soon we'll come to I'll try to come with a different case, a different virtual slide, and hope it was kind of useful, at least to a few of you. Thank you.